Good morning. My name is Bobby. Welcome to Orange City Methodist Church. Those of you who are watching online, we are glad that you are joining us today. You have already heard that Pastor Ryan and wife Rachel have an addition to their family, Elizabeth Pearl, born 818. Martha's Cupboard is so thankful to have received so many plastic bags. They are also now in need of some Ziploc bags, sandwich, quart, and gallon sizes. Sunday school will be starting back up today. We have organized an age-appropriate curriculum for preschool, elementary, and youth-age Sunday school classrooms and lessons. See Heidi Stevens if you have any questions. Volunteers are still needed for the nursery. We would like to be able to rotate to give Sarah and Emily time to worship. See Heidi Stevens if you are interested. Parents' night out last Friday was a success. The kids celebrated going back to school and had a great time. The church is participating this year in the 2022 Orange City Country and Bluegrass Festival. This is a community event that will be at Valentine Park in Orange City on Saturday, September 10th. We will be setting up a tent to promote the church. We are looking to have the faces of our church to volunteer to work the event and hand out information and talk with the people of our community. If interested, again, get in contact with Heidi Stevens. Our new women's group has a name, Women of Grace. It will be meeting every second Thursday of the month for planning activities. The next event will be lunch on Monday, 8/29 at Cook's Buffet. Please call Lynn Malone. Correction? And that's in DeBerry. Okay. So that has changed. Is that on the bulletin? Or that's not on the bulletin. Okay. Yes, please get in touch with Lynn Malone before 8:25 to reserve a spot. You may have noticed that the registration notebooks are back in the aisles. Please refresh your memory and read the front cover. Then record your attendance. And we would like to welcome Reverend Bill Boyer, who will be with us on all the Sundays that the pastor's six-week paternity leave is in effect. And he brought avocados to share with everyone and get some on your way out. Thank you, sir.
Okay. I have one more announcement. Choir is returning this Wednesday, so if you feel a song in your heart and want to be up here leading everyone, that would be fantastic. We need people. We are rehearsing Wednesday at 7 p.m.
Okay. Now our affirmation of faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead. Right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From then she shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Bless the Lord, my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. People, who forgives all your iniquity, who heals all your diseases. The Lord works vindication and justice for all who are oppressed. He does not deal with us according to our sins, nor repay us according to our iniquities. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so great is his steadfast love toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, So far, he removes our transgressions from us. Bless the Lord, O angels. Bless the Lord, all his host. Bless the Lord, all his works. Bless the Lord. Our next hymn will be How Firm a Foundation, verses 1, 2, 3, and 5, number 529.
Please stand if you are able in body or in spirit. Please be seated.
We've got prayers of the people, and it's the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now our children's moment. Rebecca Best.
Thank you. All right. Good morning. All right, so you want to stand next to me, Ava? You're going to be my helper? You stand right here? Okay. So today we're going to talk about parts of the body. Remember the song, Head, Shoulders, Knees, and Toes? Do you remember that song?
I can talk a minute.
Okay, well, you tell me when you talk what this is.
B.
You're supposed to tell me what this is.
But I can tell my stuffed animals are crazy.
She's got crazy stuffed animals. This is true. All right. So this is your head, right? What are these?
That punch my ears.
Those are your ears. Okay. And what are these?
That punches me. That punches my arm.
Your hand. Okay, all right. So do we need all of our body parts?
What?
Are they all important?
You got me wet with my hand.
She's full of it today. All right, so I think all of our body parts are important, right? So let's say here I've got this like really nice ice cold water, and I want to drink this water, okay? Do I need my elbow to drink my water?
No.
I think I do, because see, like my elbow will bend, but if I didn't have an elbow, my arm would be straight like this. I don't think I'm going to be able to. It's a good thing that wasn't water. You want to pick those up for me? Okay, I think we need our elbows. So the reason I'm talking about body parts is because in the Bible, the verse we're talking about today, we're all mentioned as part of one group, kind of compared to parts of the body. Well, each person is very important in the church, right? Okay, I'll let you talk in a second. So we all have very unique special talents. We have our musicians. We have our people giving announcements, volunteers, people working with our wonderful ministries out in the community, and little comedians like Ms. Ava here to make people smile. So it's really important that we all work together and bring our unique talents into the church and just have this wonderful ministries that we can have and the wonderful witnesses that we can have. So do you want to say, you want to say a prayer real quick?
No.
Oh, okay, well, I'll say the prayer then.
No, I will do. I need your elbow to drink this water.
Well, we're going to say a prayer now, silly girl.
No, I need it. How about I drink this water?
Dear God, thank you so much. Okay, we're being a comedian. Dear God, thank you so much for all the unique gifts you have in this room here today and our church congregation as a whole and the world to do ministry and bring love to others. In your name we pray. Amen. All right, goofball. Thank you.
Happy birthday. Please stand for our next hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness. This is number 140. We are doing all the verses. I'll give you a second.
Thank you. Let us pray. Powerful, wonderful, gracious God, we offer our prayers this morning in thanksgiving for your goodness to us, for your grace and your mercy, for every gift that you pour out upon us through Christ our Lord. Let your Spirit rest in us, that we too can be a true blessing to those whom we meet and care for. And we ask for your blessing upon this congregation and upon Pastor Ryan and Rachel, for the new child among them, and for all of your gifts of life throughout the world. We do pray for peace within the world, asking the Lord to bring blessing and peace, asking in every way that those in the Ukraine who are experiencing war, and others throughout the world who are having great difficulty finding something to eat, even within our own nation, those who are hungry. And now we ask that you would pour out through us your gifts of grace and mercy, and in every way may we be blessed to be a blessing to others. And we ask it in the strong name of Christ our Lord. Amen. Well, it's good to be back with you. I left here in 1978, Rosie, and went on active duty with the Navy. Joined the Navy to see the world and moved 38 miles to Orlando, Naval Training Center, Orlando, and spent 3 years there with recruits and the nuclear power students and service school command folk, which may mean something to some of you, but others will say, eh, what's that? Well, it was good enlisted folk officers, and I appreciated my time there as well. Nancy and I were married 40 years ago. I met her at St. Barnabas, and she had three children. I had my son Bryce, and we blended two families 40 years ago, and we're grateful for that opportunity to love each other and care for our children along the way. They're all adults. They're big folks now with their own, so we're grateful for that. And let's see, what else do you need to know? But just a sense of, I was here in 1974, we worshiped in the old sanctuary across the street, and along the way, the leadership of the congregation said, we need a new building, we need a new sanctuary, we need some office space, and we need to have a new place of worship. And I said, okay, let's see what we can get done. You're sitting in it. And this building was built, I believe, finished in 76. And David Leonard from DeLand was the architect, and the construction company out of Winter Park, I don't remember exactly now, but they got it done, and we're grateful that we did. We transferred the windows, as you all probably already know. Those windows came from the old sanctuary. And if you look in the gathering room, you'll see a round window that has 1929 on it. Those windows were built and put into that sanctuary. And so when we moved across the street, ultimately that building was torn down. It was already falling apart, and it needed to be changed out. So I had the pleasure of dealing with that and helping you all have this building in which to worship through the years. And so from 78, when I went on active duty, until now, I think we're looking at 44 years, if I remember my fifth grade math, and so it's been a while. But it is a pleasure that I can be helpful to Ryan and his wife and family, and it's nice to see you again. Some of you I know very well, and others are going, oh yeah, Martha, thank you for reminding me, and I'm grateful for you as well. Alan, it's great to see you. You were a teenager 44 years ago, I think, and now he's retired. So what are you going to do? You know, time goes right on by, and so we're grateful for it. But that's enough. I'm grateful. Nancy's watching, and I hope she's smiling. And so we ask the Lord to bless all of us now as we're here together. And by the way, we did enjoy great musicians, as you all have as well, from Stetson. And we had choir, so y'all help her with choir, okay? Please. And that would be wonderful. And so We are grateful that the Lord has provided for us through the years. And the Lord has provided a holy word for us today, and we turn to the letter of Paul to the church at Ephesus, reading from Ephesians chapter 4. Lord, please bless this word to our heart, mind, spirit, and faith. I, therefore, the prisoner in the Lord, beg you to lead a life worthy of the calling to which you've been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, making every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, just as you were called to the one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. But each of us was given grace according to the measure of Christ's gift. Therefore it said, when he ascended on high, he made captivity itself a captive. He gave gifts to his people. When it says he ascended, what does it mean but that he had also descended into the lower parts of the earth? He who descended is the same one who is ascended far above all the heavens, so that he might fill all things. The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ, until all of us come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to bear maturity to the measure of the full stature of Christ. We must no longer be children, tossed to and fro and blown about by every wind of doctrine, by people's trickery, by their craftiness and deceitful scheming. But speaking the truth in love, we must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ, from whom the whole body, joined and knit together by every ligament with which it is equipped, as each part is working properly, promotes the body's growth in building itself up in love. Pardon me. Back in the dark ages, 1968, it was a good summer because I graduated from FSU, and then within a few days took the journey to Atlanta to enter seminary and to become the youth director at St. Mark's United Methodist Church in downtown Atlanta, Peachtree and Fifth. One of the high points of that summer was lemonade. Huh? Yes, lemonade. Under the linden tree out front of St. Mark's United Methodist Church. Everyone gathered on the lawn, the front lawn, right along Peachtree Street, and we all stood around and talked and enjoyed fellowship and enjoyed a nice glass of lemonade. Southern hospitality. So, the problem with all of that is that I don't remember who made the lemonade. Yeah, it's been a long time, but still, I can still see folks in lots of different situations. I'm still in touch with friends and family from up in Georgia where I was a student pastor 40 years ago, and I'm grateful for that, grateful for their friendship. But at any rate, we need to think about people who make a difference along the way in our Christian faith. And I simply ask a question. Here at Orange City United Methodist Church, who takes out the trash? Who takes out the trash? Well, you do. Others might. But at any rate, think about it. Now, it might be a custodian who's on your staff. It could be others. But what I'm asking is, and what I'm saying is, none of us are unimportant. We're all important, no matter what our task may be, what we're able to do or even unable to do. One of the best things we can do is pray. Pray for each other. Pray and do what we can for the kingdom of God. along the way. Sometimes we need to be reminded. Some years ago, there was a huge strike in the city of New York. The sanitation workers decided it was time to lobby and negotiate for more pay. So the sanitation workers stopped picking up the trash. They stopped gathering the garbage off the street. And so people had to overcome the problem, and one lady was very creative. She took some fancy wrapping paper. After she put the garbage in a box, she wrapped the box with the garbage in it with wrapping paper and put a nice big bow on top. Then she took that out and put it on the front stoop. Within minutes, it was gone. She had a way of overcoming the problem very creatively. A good lesson for the thief along the way. My point of bringing all that up is that we need those who take out the trash. We need those who do what we think as menial tasks, but they're not menial or unimportant at all. Think about those who serve here. And that's basically our theme today. How do we serve? How do we give? How do we do what we can to build up the church of Christ in this community? We all have to do what we can, but what we're thinking about today is that the Apostle Paul, in his letter to the church in Ephesus, made the point of the importance of every person in the life of this congregation and of every Christian congregation throughout the world. He said, "The whole body, joined and knit together by every ligament with it, with which it is equipped, as each part is working properly, promotes the body's growth in building itself up in love." What strikes me about this passage is that it's all inclusive. Paul was writing about the whole body. He emphasized the importance of each part. All the parts were necessary and needed in order to function properly. We forget all of this within the life of the Christian community to our detriment. A pastor once asked his wife, "Honey, how many great preachers do you think there are in the world?" And she said, "One less than you do." That kind of puts him in his place, right? So what is greatness? What is greatness? Well, if you talk to the folks on Wall Street, they'll say money and lots of it. Talk to the folks in Washington, D.C., and they'll talk about political power and lots of it. Talk to the people in Hollywood and ask them, "What do you think greatness might be?" And they'll say fame and lots of it. And there's no bad publicity where I come in. The greatest man who ever lived, if you want to talk about greatness, the greatest man who ever lived, the man who deserves to be called great, is, of course, in every sense of the word, our Lord Jesus Christ. And he had a different answer, a different answer. He said, "Whoever wants to become great must be the servant of others." Matthew 20:26. If you want to be great in God's eyes, become the servant of others. Success and greatness in the kingdom of God is far different than what it is in evidence around us today. If you want to be seen in a great and favorable light in God's eyes, then you've got to say, "Where can I serve? What can I do to help build up the body of Christ? Where can I do as Jesus did when he said, 'For even I didn't come to be served, but to serve others'?" The secret to greatness in the kingdom of God is not how many servants you have, but what kind of servant you are. I want to ask that key question today. Are you more interested in being served in the church, or are you ready to be even more of a servant than you already are? A first grade teacher asked her class, "What do you do at home to help out?" One little girl, said, "Well, I dry the dishes." Another one said, I vacuum the rug. Another one said, I walk the dog. And then she noticed that Danny at the back of the room didn't say anything. And she said to him, Danny, what is it that you do to help out at home? He said, I stay out of the way. Sometimes that happens all too often in the church. We just choose to stay out of the way, keep a low profile. We know that from lots of polls that are out there these days that only about 10% of folks who are members of a church actually have a personal ministry in that church. What was even more amazing is that 50% of church members through the years have said they really don't want to take on any extra roles. They do what they do, and most of it's not too much within the building or within the community. But three simple, quick points for us to think about. First, there is equality in the body of Christ. We're all equal. Too often we develop hierarchies. Who's in charge? Who's the most important? Who is it that we really look to totally and sort of, well, give place to them? Not just the pastor, but others. Just remember, each one is to serve. We need to remember that within the body of Christ, the only and most important position is our head, and his name is Jesus, the Christ. 32 years ago, I took a trip in my Datsun King cab, which is now called a Nissan, and there's a Nissan dealership right up the road. The story is I had that King cab and we were going to Tallahassee for a football game. I got to Williston and it started missing, no power, no nothing. It just sort of limped along. Stopped at a gas station, and then they had a mechanic way back then. Most gas stations don't have mechanics anymore, but they did. They looked at it and said, we don't know what's wrong with it. It's one of them furin sedans. Well, it wasn't a sedan, it was a truck. So anyway, they couldn't fix it. So I called a friend who was here in Orange City who had a wrecker, and he came and picked it up. He drove all the way to Williston, drove it all the way back, dropped it off at the front gate at the Nissan dealer, Datsun dealer at the time. And Monday morning, I went back in figuring it was going to be expensive. And they looked it over, came back and said, well, here's the problem. And they held up the fuel filter. It was half full of water. There was no fuel going through that. Bad gas. It was a bad load of gasoline that came from the tank into the truck. So there was no gasoline getting through the water. $2. A little part, $2. Now it's probably $50. But anyway, $2. And so I went to the parts department, bought another one after they put in a fresh one, and a screwdriver, put it in the glove compartment, because even the littlest part can make a huge difference whether you're going or not going. And each and every individual, carrying that theme over, each and every individual is important. And the church needs you. And your pastor needs you. And the choir needs you. We all are important to the working and the ministry of this church. You already knew that. And I'm grateful that you're here. I just wanted to remind you of it just a little bit more. So as we think about the future, as we think about this congregation, we need to remember that also we need to recognize and affirm the importance of all of God's people, regardless of what they do. And then we also need to remember that your role, your gift, your talent, your participation is essential. You are needed here. And if you say, well, I'm just not able to do much of anything, but I'll pray. Thank you. Thank you very, very much, because our prayers are necessary, helpful, and important. Every member is called to ministry, even just a simple prayer ministry where we pray day in and day out. But I simply ask a couple more questions. As is our custom and privilege, on the first Sunday of the month, we have Holy Communion. Who prepares the communion elements and the table? Think about those folks and be thankful. for them. Who takes out the trash? Think about them and be thankful for that. Our ushers, our musicians, the folks in the sound booth, the folks along the way, with whatever their role might be, those in the office, whoever prints the bulletins and folds the bulletins, and whoever takes care of the children, and whoever leads our music, they're all important, and you are too. You are too. And so I simply ask you to be sure to reach out and think about what opportunities you may have. When we have Holy Communion, we're grateful for those who prepare it. But there was a moment in my ministry as a young minister where I was an associate pastor at a very large church in Central Florida. And it was a moment when the church was packed. There was a baptism that day. The pastor read the liturgy. And then we took the top off of the baptismal font, looked in the font, and found that much water. Whoops. Somebody hadn't filled the water into the baptismal font. And I stood there thinking, oh my goodness, I wonder if I was supposed to do that. But at any rate, we had just enough water to put our fingers in and baptize this child. We're all needed, and whoever missed it that day, I don't know. But we're all needed, and we're grateful that we can do our jobs, we can do our ministries, we can be involved in the opportunities that are there. And we can say, thank you, Lord. Thank you for letting me serve. Thank you for letting me reach out and do what you want me to do. So please, during your prayers, give thanks for those who do those, what we think might think are little things. Be thankful for them. And be thankful also that you have the opportunity to invite family, friends, and even more importantly, strangers to come and be a part of your worship experience here at Orange City United Methodist Church. Give thanks for Pastor Ryan, absolutely, and for his family, and for all those who are a part of that family beyond what we know here. But thank God also for each one of you, and for your friends, and for those who assist, those who care, those who help us sing, those who help us give. And remember always this, one of the greatest gifts that God bestows upon us is generosity. Generosity. Generosity in his kingdom's work, that we can be a part of that, and that we can help grow the church, that we can help continue to support the ministry that happens right here in the buildings, in the community, and beyond. So in these moments, let me just ask that you remember to ask the Lord to bless those, yes, those who take out the trash, but those who do everything else that makes a difference for us as this community and as this family. Everyone is important in the kingdom of God. And may the Lord bless you as you continue to serve in his way and by his will. Thanks be to God for the opportunity. Amen. Well, I bet you one of the things we need to do is receive an offering, right, Alan?
I think we have a hymn first, and then the offering.
So I have a what?
We have a hymn first.
Okay, I'm going to do a hymn and then the offering. All right, very good. Thank you.
Please stand if you are able for our hymn. This is My Father's World, number 144. We are doing all the verses.
Thank you.
I want to hear everyone sing.
This is my Father's world, and to my Thank you. give thanks for God's blessing to us all. God, from whom all blessings flow, praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him, heavenly host, praise from earth and holy ghost. Oh Lord, please bless these gifts, even as we ask your blessing upon those who have shared in their generosity. Let your kingdom's work continue here and beyond into the world, and we ask you would bless those in special need, even as we care for them through our gifts. We offer it all in Christ our Lord. Amen.
Sing our final hymn, Standing on the Promises, number 374. We are doing all the verses.
Thank you.
And now would you receive a blessing? May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you. May the Lord lift up his face upon you and give you peace. And the blessings of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all now and forevermore. Amen.